It's Ramsey Dewey over here in Shanghai, China. Welcome to this edition of Q&A with the Coach. By the way, if you have questions for the next edition of Q&A with the Coach, just leave them in the comments down below. And check out this hoodie from our friends at xmartial.com. They make hoodies and t-shirts and streetwear, as well as their fightwear, like rash guards, fight shorts, boxing gloves, MMA gloves, mouth guards, etc. Everything you need to kit yourself out for fight training. Go check them out at xmartial.com, and don't forget to use my code RAMSEY10, all one word, RAMSEY10, for 10% off your entire purchase of everything on the website at xmartial.com. On to the questions. Our friend Peter says, have you ever learned something from bad women's self-defense videos? If you don't know, I've tested out a bunch of bad women's self-defense videos on this channel. I have a whole playlist, MMA Fighters Try Women's Self-Defense. Go watch it. It's hilarious. I'm serious. And Peter says, and I don't mean that you learn something necessarily from watching the bad self-defense videos, but rather while stress testing any of these, has it ever inspired you to consider something that you hadn't before? Not the technique being demonstrated in the video, but I kind of, well, this is dumb, but you know, since I'm in this position, I've actually never thought about doing this. Let's see if that's better. Nope. I have not had that experience with bad women's self-defense videos. They are just so phenomenally bad. And the positions, let's talk about the positions, why they're so phenomenally bad. It's not just the bad techniques. It's the silly, imaginary positions that they put themselves in to defend themselves from. These women's self-defense videos are a disease. No. I've got this backwards. They are a cure looking for a disease. A cure looking for a disease. This happens in the pharmaceutical industry a lot. They'll invent some drug or discover some drug and be like, well, we have a lot of this stuff. If only we could sell it. Let's invent some diseases to make people feel like we need this. We need this medication. Let's go. Yeah, that happens. 100% that happens. Cures looking for diseases. That's what these positions are. Like, almost every one of these women's self-defense courses shows a bad guy coming up behind the woman and placing his hands on the shoulders and squeezing the traps, not the neck, but the traps, and saying, it's a defense for a choke from behind. Like, no, it's really not. You're giving somebody a gentle back massage, and maybe you don't want a gentle back massage, but that's definitely not a choke from behind. You don't choke somebody from behind by grasping their trapezius muscles with your fingers and going like that. I mean, the situations are nonsense. They're not situations you will find yourself in a real fight. If you do like 5 minutes of clinch sparring, just 5 minutes of clinch sparring, meaning just get somebody who's going to fight back, who's going to spar with you, and just grab, try to fight for dominant grips and land some body shots, land some knees to the legs or the body while you're doing it, and just pummel for position, or try to take the back, try to lift your partner up, try to take him down, do some really basic rudimentary stuff like that. It doesn't have to be hard. You will learn infinitely more than you ever will from going through any of these silly women's self-defense things. Why? One, it's real. And two, you're going to go through immediately almost every single real clinching position that you're going to be in, zero of which are going to be the fingers to the traps, gentle back massage, choke from behind nonsense that's always taught in these. So, what I've learned from these women's self-defense videos is that nobody who has made any of these has ever actually experienced any real violence before. They've never actually seen real violence before. They've never even done their due diligence of, I don't know, going to YouTube and just looking up recorded videos of attacks of any kind before. And YouTube filters out the more extreme violence, but I mean, if you watch the news, if you watch the news and see like CCTV footage of somebody being attacked. It's usually a guy runs out and like grabs you, throws you on the floor, grabs the hair and starts, you know, swinging haymakers and glomming onto the head and all this stuff. And it's pretty easy stuff to emulate. It's pretty easy stuff to observe. And in zero of these women's self-defense videos do they ever present real situations. It's phenomenally stupid. But going back to this question, have I ever had an epiphany while going through these situations thinking, let's see, how can we make this better? Once again, no, I haven't been inspired by that. What I have been inspired by was my series, Let's Try Out Flippy Dippy Instagram Jiu-Jitsu. So, there are a lot of impractical looking jiu-jitsu techniques that you will see on Instagram. And generally, the more impractical, the fancier it looks, the more rolling, spinning, twisting stuff there is, the more clicks and views and likes these reels are going to get on the internet. If it's not eye-catchy, if it's some guy saying, all right, hey guys, I'm going to show you the principles of guard retention, skip, they're going to scroll right past it. But if you show a flippy-dippy, spinning, triple somersault thingy, people are going to be like, oh, that caught my attention for 2 seconds. So I made a series testing some of that stuff out, and what was interesting about that was how much of that stuff actually works and is quite practical in spite of the fact that it looks fancy. Some people think if there's as much as a quarter turn in a technique, oh, that's too fancy. I must stand perfectly still and do nothing, or a technique is not practical. So, yeah, check out my series. Let's try Flippy Dippy Instagram Jiu-Jitsu if you want to see some actual aha learning moments like, well, that's pretty dang cool. So there's your answer to the question. If you have additional questions, please leave them in the comments down below. Thanks for watching. Now get out there and train.